is that kind of thinking and reiteration more associated with startups? Is that something that we that businesses need to take on, that kind of approach?
Well, if you look at the nature of disruption and the nature of startups, let's call startups disruptors because they're trying to do something somebody hasn't done before. And if you look at what enables all disruptive innovation, what you will find is there is a latent, overlooked customer need. You can pick virtually any disruptor and ask what allowed that organization to enter the market. What is allowing Uber and Lyft to disrupt the taxi service? What allowed Netflix to disrupt Blockbuster? And every single time you answer that question, what you're going to find is there was a frustrated customer somewhere, and that frustrated customer had a need, they had a problem, or they had an aspiration that was being ignored by everybody. So startups are just a manifestation of that thinking. But there is absolutely no reason why an incumbent, an established provider, cannot use that thinking to feed a different part of its portfolio. So if you're an incumbent, what you're ultimately trying to do is you're trying to run two parallel innovation models at the same time. You're trying to run a sustained innovation model, which is improving what's already there. You're trying to run a reframing innovation model, which is trying to find these latent or overlooked opportunities in a market. But the trick is they are fundamentally different innovation cultures. We call them different innovation governance models. And when you look at the culture and the management model for sustaining innovation and for reframing innovation, you will find they differ on every strategic dimension. They differ on strategic intent. Sustaining innovation wants to improve what's already existing, and you want to become best in class. The strategic intent of reframing innovation is to create what doesn't exist and to become unique class. The time frame is different. Time frame for sustaining innovation is 6 months to 2 years. Time framing for reframing innovation is 2 to 10 years. The amount of information we have about it, about the opportunity, is totally different. With sustaining innovation, we know everything. We know the customer, we know the segments, we know the features of the product, we know the competitors. With reframing innovation, we know nothing. And if somebody says they have an answer to the business case question, they're not telling you the truth. The key success factors are different. The key success factor in sustaining innovation is time to market. You've got competitors breathing down your neck. Who gets there first? With reframing innovation, you normally don't have a competitor, you're pioneering. But you have another challenge. You have to prove the concept and you have to educate the market because the customer doesn't actually know what you're about to do. And the great case there is TiVo. TiVo was the first digital video recorder. And they had to spend 10 times the amount of money that they spent on product development trying to educate the market about what is a digital video recorder and how do you use it and how do you get the most out of it. So we go through all of the dimensions of business case analysis and business planning, and what we find is these are two radically different innovation cultures. And unless the leaders of an organization understand those differences, what happens is all of the great ideas get sucked into one business case model. And it's a business case model that was designed to support sustaining innovation. So all of the great reframing ideas either never make it through, or they get compromised, or they get delayed. And I think this is the greatest challenge for an incumbent, is to understand you need this mix of sustaining and reframing. You need to understand that they are radically different innovation governance models and cultures and leadership models, and they're different business case models, and you need to run them separately, but in parallel. What you cannot do is ask the same team to do both. You need two different teams, each of them running under a very different innovation model.